Yeah. How is everyone doing? Okay. So let's talk about these questions before we move on to the next activity, which is reviewing the vocabulary from last week. Do you remember some of the words from last week?
Yeah.
Don't worry, we will review them in just a minute. But first, let's talk about these questions. Has anyone here seen a doctor in the US before? Thank you. Two of you? Three? Okay. And no one else? Okay. It's what?
Too
expensive. It's too expensive. Yeah. What about those who have seen a doctor? What was it like? Do you think it's easy to see the doctor?
I like dentist. Because of my things are wrong. And I went to dentist. I asked about expensive
price
via email. After that I went and for one debt he even if he from Turkey, he's from Turkey, $1,250.
Wow.
And he said me, you can think about this for 2 weeks maybe. And I still thinking about it.
Yeah, like you were saying, it's very expensive. Healthcare in the US, seeing a doctor. And that is why a lot of people here actually go to the pharmacy to get medication, medicine instead of going to a doctor, because it takes time, it costs a lot. So getting medicine from CVS is much easier. How about flu shots? Have you heard of flu shots or flu vaccines before?
Yeah.
What have you had? Can someone tell me what a flu shot or a flu vaccine is? What do you do with it, or when do you get it?
To prevent the flu.
To prevent the flu. So before you get the flu, or after? Before. Can you get it after you? It doesn't make sense. Yeah. Actually, they do tell people that if you have a cold or have a flu, then you cannot have a flu shot. You have to be very healthy when you get a flu shot. Why is that? Why do you think is that? Why do you think doctors recommend against getting a flu shot when you have a flu?
Because when you have a flu, your body is already fighting against the flu. So if you get the flu shots, when you have the flu shots, it's a little part of the flu, just a little. So you can have both at the same time, because your organs is going to be too tired to fight it.
Yes, exactly. That's right. So, we're just talking about flu shots. And there are name tags if you would like to. Here's the same sheet. We were just talking about flu shots. And we are at the last one. Have you gotten one before, or do you plan to get one this year? Has any one of you gotten a flu shot before this year? Yes? Some of you? Yes?
I have the flu shot just 1 week ago.
Oh, wow. Okay. And
always with a little pain in my arm after the
Yes. of you who have gotten a flu shot, other than you know, the pain in the arm, what else have you experienced? Was it a bad experience? It was for you?
Some of my friends said that they got sick.
They got sick, yeah. Yeah.
Just by
one. Uh-huh. Okay.
But just for one or two days.
I see. Lucky. You're lucky. You didn't get sick. How about those who didn't get a flu shot? Would you consider getting one? No? Do you think it's necessary?
No.
Not really? Like, it's fine. Like, I don't need one.
This is not about babies and older person. It's not all the people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you work with babies?
Uh-huh.
It's good to have, not really for the youth, but more for the babies, because it's going to be difficult for them.
Yeah.
So just to prevent the food for the babies, but if you're in good health, even if you have the fruits, like bad days,
uh-huh.
but it's not dangerous.
Yeah.
And every winter it changes.
Mm-hmm.
So you have, if you want to don't have the flu,
mm-hmm.
you have to have the flu shots every winter. So
yeah, that's a good point.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone heard what you just said?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so sometimes we might be very healthy. We don't think it's necessary for us, but it might be important for babies or someone who cannot get a flu shot. That protection from us. So now we're going to take a look at these. This is to, I believe some of you will recognize the words. they are from last week. And the paragraphs, the paragraph is for the topic today. We're going to talk about flu shots. And that's because from the questionnaire last week, most of you suggested that like talking to or seeing a doctor or talking to a doctor can be a little more difficult than the other topics, and it's something that you're interested in. So let's take a few seconds and read through the paragraph and think about what word, which word you might want to put in the blank. You can work on your own or you can, you know, talk to your neighbor. What is this? And we will go through this together later. Okay, is everyone ready? Is it too difficult? Okay, how about we look at the paragraph together? And I have someone read for us the first sentence, the first line, the first three sentences.
It is the time of the year.
Uh-huh.
It is not a Halloween or Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
It's the flu season.
Yes, it's the
flu season. It can be something
mm-hmm.
for our elders and younger ones and those with health challenges.
Yes, very good. Thank you very much. So, what do you put in this blank, in the first one?
Awkward.
It's awkward. It is intimidating. Why do you think it's awkward?
I don't know.
So
it can be too bad for our elder or young people.
Yeah. And what about intimidating? Why do you think it's intimidating?
I would mean bad.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Not
like,
too good. Not so good.
Yeah. So when you feel like that's it, feeling awkward.
Mm-hmm.
But what about intimidating? What does he mean? Is that intimidating?
I think yes, because of the pain.
Uh-huh.
I think because they are more, how can I say, more, to
sensitive?
Get a flu, they are more exposed to the flu.
Yeah, yeah. They can be exposed to the flu, that's right. So again, when we see like a new word, or maybe a word that we're not sure, oh, forgot to take that out. So we can see the other part of the sentence to get some clues. So for example, before this blank, we have the flu season, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it usually starts at fall, like around this time of year. It can go to spring next year. And then we have elders, like older people, younger people, like small children,
mm-hmm.
and those people who have health challenges, some patients in hospitals. So for them, because they might have weaker immune system, so flu season can be intimidating,
mm-hmm.
right? Because it can be something serious.
Mm-hmm.
It can be bad for their life. And why is it not awkward? Because awkward is more like when we are talking with people and it's weird, it's uncomfortable. But here, when it comes to health, it can be life-threatening. So that's why we can put intimidating there. And let's just pretend that I So, can I have the next person reading another
It can be intimidating for our elders, young ones, and those with health challenges.
Mm-hmm.
The good news is that now we can leverage technology to help manufacture vaccines.
Yes, good. Thank you very much. So, let me put down this as And then you said this is leverage.
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean? What does this sentence say? We can leverage technology. What is another word we can say?
Leverage technology.
How can we say
use technology or?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. So last week we saw that leverage is the same word as use, right? So to use something to its full extent, to make good use of something, and we're leveraging it. So we can use technology or we can leverage technology to help manufacture vaccines. Okay. And what does manufacture mean? So what do we use with technology? We use technology to
make?
Yes, exactly. Thank you. It is made. To make something in large quantity, that is to manufacture. So we can make a lot of vaccines. Okay. So this is leverage. And can I have another student? One of you to read the next sentence with?
With flu vaccines, are flu shots give you stronger immunity to the flu than the unit eats?
Good, thank you. So, what's the clue in this sentence? We have stronger immunity. Immunity is like, you know, the strength and power we have to fight diseases. And then the blow when the illness hits. So what does our immunity or our immune system does? What does it do?
Can I say caution?
Uh-huh.
The flow when the illness hits.
Why is that? What does it mean?
So like help the blow or just like to make it help our body protect against the the flu virus.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. So, do you remember what Kushan means? Sort of like to protect, to make something less strong or to make something less hard.
Don't say minimize.
To minimize this?
Yeah.
You mean
minimize
here?
The effect. No.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. It's like it has the same meaning. So last week the example that I gave is that if the chair is very hard, you can put a cushion so that it's not as hard. So here it's similar. The illness is, you know, the flu can be serious, but when we have strong immunity, okay, cushion, that blow. Okay. How about the next one, next sentence?
There are various types of vitamins, such as IRV, the acronym that stands for Inactivated Influenza Vaccine.
Vaccine. Yes. Thank you. That's very good. So, yeah, you put acronym.
Yeah.
Uh-huh, because...
It was so clear.
Yeah, so acronym, IIV is an acronym.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So what does it stand for? It stands for inactivated influenza vaccine. What's influenza?
It's like influenza.
It's the same as flu. It is flu. But is flu the acronym for influenza?
No.
Why is it not? No, what is it?
It's part of a word. It's like, I don't know.
So we call this acronym, right?
Yeah.
Because how do we come up with IIV? Yeah, so for an acronym, we take the first letter
mm-hmm.
of each word, right? But for flu, it's just this part, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's not the first letter. So for this type of word, we call it abbreviation instead of... Yeah. So abbreviation is like shortening.
Mm-hmm.
Make it short.
Mm-hmm.
So flu, last week we talked about acronym, but flu is not an acronym, it's abbreviation, abbreviating influenza.
But so can I say like, I got the influenza?
Yes.
Like, mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's just that flu is so much easier, short. Okay, thank you for reading that. I have next. Thank you, please.
Some people do not think that it is necessary to get a flu shot every year.
Mm-hmm.
So doctors have to give some bank for why it is a good idea for people to get it.
Okay. What is your answer for this one?
Relational.
I'm not sure.
So what is recreation?
Excuse me?
What is that? What does it mean?
Give some relational
advice.
Advice?
But
there is no advice in
the show. Oh, yes, that's right. So you said it's the same as advice?
No, not exactly.
It's the same reason.
Huh? Yeah.
It's some reason.
Yes.
Medical reason
mm-hmm.
why they have to.
Yes. So you're right. It is rationale. So it's. It means reason.
Mm-hmm.
It's a reason for doing this. So doctors give some rationales, give some reasons.
Give rationales.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why is that? You said?
No, because we have some.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's right. Not just one.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Thank you for pointing that out. And then let's go on. The next one.
Mm-hmm.
We have four more.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Please.
You can tell that you are getting sick when you don't have smooth breathing.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Right. Thank you. So here we put smooth breathing.
Mm-hmm.
So what does it feel like when you do not have smooth breathing? Yes, like coughing, right? So that's a sign that
mm-hmm.
you're sick. So the next one. Who hasn't read a sentence?
Mm-hmm. Okay, some signs such as headache are far shallow that the flu is on its way. But when you're sick, it can be too late.
Yes, thank you. That's very good. But here, you said it's foreshadow, right? Do we need an S here for shadows, or no? Yes, very good. The subject in the sentence is some signs, so we don't need S, we just need foreshadow. And what does this mean? What does this sentence say? What does it mean when it says some signs such as a headache foreshadow that the flu is on its way?
Prediction?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's like a prediction. It's telling you that something is about to happen, something is going to happen. Yeah. And one last sentence. Well, two last.
A lot of times in the morning, he has something in the moment.
Mm-hmm. These two blanks, what do you have?
Roll down the tubes.
Uh-huh.
First one.
Yes.
And the other one, off the hook.
Off the hook. Okay. Why is the first one go down the tubes? What does it mean that time and money can go down
the tubes? Wasting of time and money If you are too late to have a push-up, then just wasting both time and money.
Yes, very good. It's like wasting it.
Mm-hmm.
Just go waste it.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Thank you. And the second one is to get you off the hook. Do you have the same answer?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So if you get a push-up, it gets you off the hook. What does it mean?
Protect you.
Mm-hmm.
Out of the illness.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good. It's out of danger. Thank you very much. So we complete the first paragraph. Well, the only paragraph only have one. So, review some of the words from last week. So, just to refresh our memory a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And also, this paragraph tells us a little about what a flu shot is and what it does. Now, we are going to take a look at some noun clauses in this paragraph. So, what is a noun clause? Let's begin with the easiest question. Have you heard of a noun clause before? No?
Yes.
What about a noun? What is a noun?
It is not a verb or adjective.
it's not a verb, it's not an adjective. Usually. Huh?
Is that a verb? That indicates a time, an action. Yeah.
It's a word that
indicates time and action.
Does not. Yeah. It's a verb will be an action. So usually a noun is like a thing. So you can say a water bottle. This is what? Well, water bottle is a noun. What about a clause? A clause is like a sentence, right?
Mm-hmm.
So,
sentence.
Yeah, it's not a complete sentence. So when we say a noun clause, it's almost like saying this clause works like a noun. in a sentence. Okay, so what is an example of a noun clause? Do you see any noun clause in this paragraph?
That's nice.
Wait, where is that?
You can tell that you are getting sick.
Yes.
That.
Okay.
Some people don't think that it is necessary.
Good. Yes.
The acronym that stands for.
So, so just mark these sentences. What is the first one? I lost track. You said the first one is, you can, oh, you can tell that. So this one. So a lot of time when you see a that after a verb, like say, tell, think, that's usually a noun clause, because you can tell. What can you tell? You can tell this, right?
Mm-hmm.
This whole thing. So, what is it? Sound good? So this is an example of a noun clause. You can tell, so we have a subject here, you, and we have a verb, tell, here, right? So this whole thing is a clause, but at the same time, it is the object in this sentence. It is something that you tell, right? So it is a noun clause, because it works like a noun here. It's something, it is something that you can tell.
Mm-hmm.
And another example that you mentioned, where is it?
Not here. Some people don't think that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like this. So what's the subject in this sentence?
Some people.
Yeah, what about the verb?
Think.
Good. So what do some people think?
That's blah,
blah. Yeah, that, the, this whole clause,
mm-hmm.
everything that goes after that, right? So
mm-hmm.
what do you think? I think that the, and that whole thing is a noun clause. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So some of the things, a lot of time, we use noun clause to express our opinions, to tell what we think, or to report what other people say. That is a really useful way to use noun clauses. Okay,
mm-hmm.
So we can say, he said that, blah, 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 or the doctor explained,
that.
Yes, that. And then that's the sentence, that's the clause. So today we're going to practice using noun clauses, mostly that, to talk about flu shots, and also to present arguments. Like, this is why I believe that. Okay, so these are some of the examples of noun clause.
Question.
Yes.
Is it obligatory to use that, or can you just say some people do not think it's necessary to get a flu shot every year?
That's a very good point. A lot of time that can be, yes, be omitted like this. Thank you. May I not? So we can also say some people do not think it is necessary to get a flu shot every year. And then, when we hear that, we know that there is that here. It's just that we can't simply do without it. What about this one?
Yeah.
Okay, we can also do without this. You can tell. Oops. You can tell your. Oh, that's what it is. You can tell your days. And you do not have to smoke your pen. Okay. So this is the most common noun clause that we will see and we will use in daily lives. When we read an article, when we hear people talking, that is the most common. But there are a few other types of noun clauses. Can you think of any?
What?
Yes. What is also a type of noun clause.
Weather.
Weather, yes. Good. Weather is also and a type of noun clause. And when do we use them? When do we use these different words for noun clauses? So that is the first type of noun clause.
Mm-hmm.
You say what, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we have whether.
Yeah.
And if. Can any one of you think of
when?
Okay. Yes.
Why?
So basically all of the all of the question words, yes. So the first type is that. It's simply stating something, right? And that is the noun clauses. That is a noun clause where we can omit that. So and then we have a clause. This is the first type of noun clause. And then we have all the question words.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So, we can say something like, tell me something. And then we can put a noun clause over here. Like, tell me.
What do you want?
Okay, tell me, can you say that again?
What do you want?
This is what I hear. Tell me what do you want? Okay.
What do you want?
What do you want?
Okay, good. Why is that? Because this is not a real question.
Yeah.
It's a noun clause.
Yeah.
So even though it's a question word, we're not asking a question.
Mm-hmm.
If we are really asking a question, we will say, what do you want?
Mm-hmm.
But here, we're using this as a noun clause.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me something. And that something is something you want. So tell me what you want. So in this case, we do not need to because it's not a question.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. And what about whether and if? We use whether and if noun clause when we're talking about
two things.
Yes or no.
Awesome.
Yeah. That's right. So for example, I could say, I do not know, can I get a, someone help me complete the sentence? I do not know whether
she comes or not.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, so I do not know. She might be coming, she might not be coming. So, comparing two things. yes, she is, or no, she is not. Very good, thank you. And whether, and oftentimes, we can use whether and if interchangeably. Okay, so this is the construction, the basic construction of a noun clause, like the one we see here. Most of the time we will see a subject, a verb, and then following that verb, we will have that, or a question word. Oh no, question words, not questions, or whether and if. Okay, now we're going to read an article about flu shots. And then before that, we're going to break into four groups. Mm-hmm. So we have, how many people? We have 14. So about three in a group. We might have okay, so this is for the first group. This is for the second group. And do we have two groups here? Activity, we're going to first summarize the article, the paragraph we have. So think about these questions. Okay, think about these questions. What is the main idea of this paragraph? How does the writer make an argument? Does she cite any sources to support her argument? How does she cite those sources? Okay. I'll put the questions up here where you discuss in the group.
What?
Okay, so after you have read a paragraph, you can discuss with your neighbors, think about these questions, and when you are doing that, at the same time, think about the words in the paragraph that you do not know. You can highlight them, and we can talk about them later, or talk to your neighbors, your group members, to see if you can figure out what it means.
Mm-hmm.
And also, look for noun clauses. How do we find a noun clause? Like these?
Mm-hmm.
That. Sometimes it is omitted. So look for verbs like say, think, believe. Sometimes it's right there. And also question words can be So look for noun clauses in a paragraph as well. And then, after the discussion, we will come up with one sentence that summarizes the paragraph. It's like, you know, giving a title. It's like you're an editor, and you want to give this paragraph a title. So think about what sentence is the best to summarize to give the idea of this paragraph. And start the discussion. How come your partners?
But it's not that it's one or two days. It's not a long
time.
It's because you put the sick blood. You don't have really one, so you can have like all your system can fight and have all the animal usage. And so when you have the real flu, your body is ready to fight.
That's a good question. We will come to that later. So, according to what you said, the main point in this paragraph is the two goals. What the goal of the vaccine.
It's like you did the vaccine for nothing, so you had to wait for 2 days for nothing.
You can give that paragraph a heading, like a title, like what you will have for an article. For the newsletter, this is the title. You can write down one sentence to summarize this paragraph, and also look for the noun clause. Put them in a bracket. What do we have here?
So she's giving some
And also what she does,
yes, that's a good point. You can poke someone, right? Like specialists, experts, doctors.
Explanation. Not really that she explains it because
we got the mental shots.
So do you have one sentence, like kind of like a heading for this paragraph?
So I think she is giving explanation.
But you know, the main point in this paragraph. So that the readers who read the sentence can know instantly, right away, what this paragraph is about. This paragraph is about. Do you have the main idea in this paragraph?
Usually that's the case. That's right.
It's not my idea, but we have to say that.
The benchmark of this?
Of sight.
Sight.
Mm-hmm.
Which is like the nose structure.
To the person.
Say, don't worry.
Yeah. The writer said.
That's it.
City.
But the sign is when you buy resources. Like I can say what I want. Yeah, but like from this source of studies and everything, because some doctors say, yeah, you should have the flu shot, and some say you should not have it.
But say, don't I know, I think.
Yes.
And it's information.
Yeah, that's a good question. We can discuss that when we come together.
Okay.
Yeah, like what is, what do we say? What do we
say? Is it
yeah, try to write
like something. But why she said that? That's an argument, but because it is
apologize.
You need to know where she was that. Like if it's actually a book,
well,
I don't know who, but
I don't know.
Yeah, for
so
example, yeah.
So what are the two you were thinking?
Condition, if you make other
got to learn flu shots last year.
But yeah, it's easy, but you have to be 100 people.
Just start waiting the summer. Start waiting the summer.
They have good response, and there's nothing wrong with the body.
Yeah, there is some to write some
So if they come up with a response,
so the first ones,
so they might get a flu,
no,
they say, and they might
you get a flu shot,
they have other
like,
things,
let's say that you have,
I thought it was like, I'm gonna wait like
one thing.
Yeah, but like, I think it, when you, yeah, right, you should refresh it, because like that is
immune system.
So we can just copy it for now, and then think about it later.
Okay.
So let's get back together and we can have each group tell us something about your paragraph. Okay. So the paragraphs that you have, each group has a different paragraph, but they're all from one article. So one group gets the first paragraph, another gets the second paragraph. So they're actually the first, second, third, and the fourth paragraph. You don't know which one you get. So what we're going to do is we're going to share with your classmates the main idea, something that you have found in the paragraph. And then using that information, we're going to try to find out, yes, which paragraph is the first. Because there are some clues in the paragraph. Okay, so why don't we start with you? What is your paragraph about? Maybe the main idea, something that you found, or the title with the heading to create.
The main idea for us is the doctors recommend carrying the vaccine as soon as it's available. Which is the main idea?
Yes, the main idea.
Is that doctor recommend getting it as soon as it's available.
Okay,
good. Our is because there are several types of flu viruses.
Let me write them down. So, first we have doctors recommend
getting it as soon as it's available.
As soon as
it's available.
And then we said there are
several types of flu viruses.
What about flu vaccines? Are there different flu vaccines because there are different types of flu viruses? Yes? Okay. And then, here we go. Your group? What is that?
The title or the main idea?
The main idea.
Main idea is the primary goal of the flu vaccine.
The primary goal for the flu vaccine are
for the main idea. First of all, reduce the number of flu illnesses.
Reduce the number of illnesses, you said?
Yeah, flu illnesses. And also to build a herd immunity.
To build herd immunity.
Okay. Right, you missed an article. A herd.
Oh, thank you. the last one.
If your immune system give you a good response when you got a flu shot, then immune system give you a good response when you got a flu shot.
Gives you a good response?
Yeah.
And you?
Got a flu shot. Then it will be impossible. Impossible for you to catch the flu.
Okay. So these are the four main ideas we have. Okay. Which group do you think?
The first.
Yeah, it's first.
Okay.
Which group do you think that you got the first paragraph? Like the beginning. Is there something in your paragraph that says this is the beginning of an article?
The third one.
Let me label that. So this is A. In your paragraph, you should have seen two persons, right? Who are they?
Sean and Dr. Shelley.
Do you know who they are? Who is that?
Dr. Michael Chang.
Who else has that information in your paragraph?
The scientist, Chang.
The scientist?
Chang.
Okay.
We have another one, Dr. Megha Tiwari.
Okay. Who is she?
A family medicine doctor.
Okay.
Memorial Primary Medical Group.
Does other group, do other groups have that person in your paragraph? No?
Yeah, the name, but we don't have the information.
Only the name,
yeah.
Right? So, do you think the first time that name appears, what would the writer do?
Explain
who this person is, right? So, if you have, if in your paragraph, the writer tells you who that person is, it probably goes before the other paragraph. So, who has that?
Maybe.
Okay. And what about the other person? There's another doctor, right? And you have the information?
Yeah, a family medicine doctor at Memorial Hermann Medical Group.
I see. Do you have Dr. Michael Chang?
Yeah.
No?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You do? So, that says something, right? And the main idea is that there are several types of flu viruses. So, what does it look like a beginning of an article? So that information about the person, about the doctor, is a clue. And what about the main idea? Do you think this?
I guess that B is the first, because it talks about flu viruses. So like they have and then you go to the, and then there, which is A, I guess.
And then it's like, it is like the flu shot. It just, you know, first you keep like, well, it starts and then like,
yeah, that's a good point. Like, talk about viruses first and then. So, you think that B is the first paragraph?
I think.
And then A is the second?
Yeah.
Okay. What about others? What do you think?
I think
C.
Yeah.
But there is a reference this one because the doctor said you have to get the image every year. So maybe the next paragraph will give some explanation about this. So it must be C.
C.
I think C, A, and D, and after.
Is
it
the last one?
Yeah. Is the explanation of the vaccine and then order you explain about the vaccine you do? About the opinion of doctors. And then order you explain your argument about this.
Okay. Now let's see. So the first paragraph is who has the first, we call it the flu, like there's only one who has the you got it correct?
Yeah.
Yay. And the second one is scientists grow the vaccines either in Japan.
Oh my god.
And the third one is now let's say okay. And the last one is ultimately the flu vaccines.
Okay.
But you have the first one right. Right? that's because, like you said, we talk about viruses before we talk about vaccines. But let's see some of the things that are in the article that told us why this paragraph comes before others. So here we see this. Dr. Michael Chang, a pediatric infectious disease specialist. So he has a title. This usually appears in the beginning, the first time we mention someone, right? So we see that the main idea of the first paragraph, which is the is that there are several types of flu viruses. Talking about viruses, there are more than just one virus, because there are different types of flu viruses, it is important that we get flu vaccines every year because it's always changing. And then, after we talk about viruses, then we go to vaccines, right? This is where he talks about the vaccines. Some people get reactions, but do you get sick from getting a flu shot? Do I hear from the group? Do you get the flu from the flu shot?
No.
What does the paragraph guess? Viruses in the vaccine are dead is a critical point. A dead virus cannot infect you. Yeah, so some people say, like you were saying, that some of your friends who got a flu shot got sick, right? But did they get a flu?
them?
No.
No. But they have some.
Yeah, they were sick because of the reactions, yeah, but they are not, they did, it didn't really get a flu. And then, why is this paragraph the third paragraph? There is something about this paragraph that tells you it must come after another one.
You didn't get sick because of the vaccine.
Uh-huh, and then?
But it was pretty good.
Yeah, here it says you didn't get sick because of the vaccine. Because, again.
That viruses are not.
Infectious. What does she say again?
Because it refers to
yes.
Last paragraph.
Yes, she's referring to this paragraph, so that is why this comes after. And then, when does this one come last? Because you see this person's name here, right?
Mm-hmm.
So who is she? She is a family of Mexican medicine doctor. Her title is here. How we piece together. Okay. So. Good job. And then. Now let's move on. After we have talked about the main ideas and you have discussed how she makes her arguments, what are some of the noun clauses you have identified in your paragraph? So let's start with the first paragraph, which is groupie.
People have died of the epidemic, without a girl, at the
second. Every winter we know that
mm-hmm.
will.
Yes.
Good. So this is a noun clause, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we know something. So what do we know? We know this.
Yes.
Okay.
And with three or four, you prove to be the seasons, not three and then the
seasons. Okay, very good. With three or four, will prove to be the seasons. Okay, can you tell me why this is a noun clause?
Because it starts with which.
It's not what?
It starts with which.
With the question word, which,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, with the question word, and it modifies the first sentence.
First sentence. Okay, so scientists predict. So we have predict. It's a verb, right? So what do scientists predict? This whole thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like which three or four viruses. Good. Is there another one?
Yeah, and the last one, and the last sentence,
mm-hmm.
From that happened,
okay, this one.
Yeah.
Okay. That. Is this a noun clause?
No.
Why is it not?
It's not a
verb.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have something else called.
Noise?
Yes. So earlier we say that a noun clause is something he say that. He says that, I believe that. So it follows a verb, right? So, like, what do we know? We know this. What do scientists predict? They predict this. But this, that, there, what comes before that? It's not a verb, right? It's a noun. So this is not a noun clause. It is an adjective clause. Yeah. So an adjective clause is a clause that works like an adjective to modify the noun before it. Good. But I think you've pointed out. Okay. Okay. Now we can move on to the second paragraph. Do you see any?
So first there's a fact. Like the values, it's a close, non-close.
Mm-hmm.
The
noun.
Right, a noun. So is it a noun clause or is it an adjective clause?
Adjective clause.
Is it an adjective clause? Okay.
People say, we'll say.
Is there that here?
No.
No.
Doctor.
So what happened here? What happens here? They met that, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
No, fresh for some questions that you should.
Where is that?
All the child patients.
So this whole thing is a net cross.
Look at your who? No. Who?
Where is that? Which one is that?
Change notes.
Look
at you.
So what do they have in common? They all come after a verb, right? So people say that. And the doctor, Dr. Chang, I always tell patient that. And then
she knows.
So other than say or tell, you can also say.
Or that's good news. Or after all, that's good news that she didn't go.
Who? The last
song.
This is why doctors.
In the first paragraph.
In the first paragraph, this is why doctors come in.
Yes, so we also have a question word.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Mm-hmm. Question word and after the. And the next one is how long the vaccine lives in your system?
Mm-hmm.
I think so. I'm not sure.
But this one?
Yeah. Before your this stuff.
Before what? What do you think?
Which cancer has the immune system?
Question mark.
So how long is a question word, right?
Yeah.
But this time, does it come after a verb?
So something.
No.
Before
a verb, because like you said, it is a subject. So where does a noun appear in a sentence? It can be a subject.
Subject, object.
Yes, an object. So same with a noun clause. It can be a subject and it can also be an object. So in this case, this sentence, the noun clause is
subject.
A subject. The subject is not the clause.
Mm-hmm.
So it comes before
verb.
Great.
And which can start?
Where is that?
Before. If you get the message now, you should get it.
This one?
No.
Okay, which, it also looks like a question, it's also a question word, but... Is it, is there a verb before it or after? Why do you think it's an adjective clause? What does this do? Which can start as early as mid-fall? What can start as early as mid-fall?
The duration of the blue season. Describes the duration of the blue season.
Yeah, so this, which can start as early as mid-fall, talks about this blue season, right? So it's an adjective clause because it works like an adjective to describe the duration or the blue season. So it's not a clause, even though it also has a question. But here, which is not that clause. Is that clear?
In the first paragraph, the first sentence, so the best is not that long with.
Does that? Is it that clause? Why do you think?
It comes after verb.
Is there a verb? Another
clause
after?
I don't think so.
Yeah, so what's after this that? It's long-lived.
Yeah.
And in part because it's another clause, right? So this, what is this that? It's used to say the vaccine is not that long-lived. It's like an intensive. Describing it to me.
Yeah.
How long it is.
Yeah. The last sentence. This is why I tell my patient.
Oh, another why.
So.
Okay. Good. Good job. And finally, the last paragraph. Recommend getting a flu shot, right? So we can use them as evidence to support our argument, just as this writer, this author, the author of this article, used what they say to support her argument. So earlier, you were saying, are they citing, is she citing, right?
What? You talked about that.
Yeah. So one of the questions that we discuss is, does she cite any sources to support her argument, and how does she cite any sources? What do you think? You talked about that, right? Uh-huh.
She quotes specialists.
Yes, she quotes specialists. The words of a specialist, some experts, right? So she quotes. That's a way to cite someone. So there are different types of citations, different ways we can cite. We can cite, like, what can we cite?
Explanation or facts.
Uh-huh.
Or
like,
like
a book. There are sources we can cite. A news article, a book
I cite.
Uh-huh. And here in this article, she doesn't cite any research papers or articles. What does she do instead?
Just some explanation of some specialists, some doctors.
Mm-hmm. Yes, some specialists.
Also, they did some experiments.
Uh-huh.
Like the scientists throw the vaccines either in chicken eggs or in specialized bacteria.
Mm-hmm.
To do some experiments.
Yeah, so she states like a fact, an explanation. Good. So we have seen some reasons, like Dr. Give, some word rationales, the words we use, and we learned last week, why doctors recommend. And now we will see some reasons why people are against getting a flu shot. So look for some arguments in this video why people do not want to get a flu shot.
What a marvelous day! Nothing gives me more joy than teaching my students about the human body. But since your children aren't vaccinated, it's incredibly unsafe for them to come to school.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just believe that vaccines are the parents' choice.
And I believe they're unnatural.
They're a conspiracy.
So instead, I'll be educating you. For though you are grown adults, you all need a lesson in biology. Let the learning begin. Observe. As the measles vaccine enters the bloodstream, the immune system is activated. You see? Those white blood cells are learning how to protect the body from the disease.
Sure, you say that, but where's the proof? Where's the evidence?
It's literally outside your window. Just turn your heads, you can see it happening. Here in the lungs, the measles virus can attack the respiratory system, which can cause pneumonia. But observe, the vaccine contains a weakened form of the disease which passes through the body harmlessly.
It also contains a ton of toxins, even mercury.
Okay, that's very wrong. Well, decades ago, vaccines contained a non-toxic variant of mercury. Today, they don't contain mercury of any kind.
Why do you think that? Because Western medicine says so?
No, because this bus can shrink down to the molecular level, and you can watch it happen. Just watch. That one's oxygen, that one is hydrogen, but no mercury. So, oh my, where did she go?
I'm healing this body the same way I heal my kids. Crystal therapy. It's a totally safe... Oh man, that was expensive.
What on earth are you doing?
We gotta take out this vaccine before it gives that kid autism! Where does that happen, by the way?
Let's see, that happens, well, nowhere. There's zero evidence that vaccines cause autism or mental disorders of any kind. Do people actually think that?
Hi, I'm Dinner Party.
Thank goodness nobody informed me.
I'm Chris Christie, and I don't believe in vaccines, and I want to be your next president.
Seriously?
Got it! That's the last one. Why is it getting so hot in here?
Without the vaccine, it appears the body is now infected with measles and is suffering from a fever of 103 degrees.
Oh dear. Bet you wish I had my crystal now.
Okay, now quickly talk to your neighbors, again in the same group, about what you have observed or what you have heard in this video using noun clauses. You can say, the parents think that, or the parents believe that, or the teacher explains that. Okay? Try to, yes, use noun clauses and talk about the arguments in this video. Okay?
Yeah.
Now we will come back together and talk about what we have discussed today, including the article and the video that we just watched. So we will talk about what the doctors suggest. One doctor suggested that. So maybe we can go around and each group can tell us one thing about the flu vaccine. Either the good thing or the bad thing. Right? Why some people recommend it, why some people don't recommend it. Okay? Like using non-clauses. Okay. And the first paragraph started us off.
The parents think that it's a choice. They can decide if they want to or not.
Okay, so does everyone hear that?
Yeah.
The parents?
One parent thinks that
here.
Yeah, the father thinks that it is a choice for an adult.
Okay, let's listen to her. The father
thinks
that
it is a choice.
A choice?
For an adult.
Okay. So it's not for children. Is that right?
No, it's a choice. It's a choice, yeah, for us.
To give your
mother
something.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Okay, good. And the next group? Can you tell us something about what we have watched and read today?
The lady was an angel because she had a, it's like, he contained mercury in it.
Uh-huh. The lady was against it because what did she say?
That
she said that
the vaccine contained mercury.
Uh-huh. The vaccine contained mercury. Okay, so mercury is a kind of, it's like a chemical, a toxic. And the lady was against it. She said that the vaccine. Did she say one vaccine? Or just vaccine in general?
I missed that part.
So maybe it's just vaccines in general, right?
I guess.
So she said that vaccines, so we can use plural to suggest that vaccines, yeah, not just one vaccine. Okay, what about the group?
The child said.
The child said?
Said that.
Who's the child?
Who's child?
The girl?
No,
yeah, said that. What is pharma's nature?
Vaccine?
Against the vaccine, I think they are generally a belief that the vaccine causes some mental problems or autism or something like that.
Okay. The people who are against
the vaccine
believe that. Good. Uh-huh.
Vaccine causes some mental problems.
Mental
problems and autism.
is that autism, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is autism a kind of disease?
A kind of disease.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Autism
disease. So it is one of the mental problems.
Yeah, I know because begin with O.
Uh-huh.
I don't know in English how it is written, but in Turkish, I think it is with O.
Okay. Let's see. Last week you have a vocabulary list, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have one for today?
Mm-hmm.
Some of the words you see in the paragraph, maybe?
Mm-hmm.
Loophole, yeah.
Huh?
Loophole. But it does point to a loophole.
A loophole?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, loophole.
Oh.
Yes. Yes, so it's loop and O. So together, loop O. That's a good word. Why don't we create our own vocabulary
mm-hmm.
list? So by the end of this course, like 5 classes, you can see, wow. So. We have learned so many words. Create a list of your own for today, for this week. And if you can send it to me, that would be great. Just give us my email. And so put on my email.
I don't know what
have you fill out this so we can, excuse me, so let me know what you think about the class today and also what you want to focus on next week or in the class, in the future classes. You guys, huh? Yes. You can put down your name or not. It depends. It's not necessary. Let's put down the date.
Where I come from, so what do you think?
No, you said it here. You said it here. Do you have any?